Well, they're at it again down there. Military jets doing the loop-de-loops in the sky. Out of Le Bourget Airport, not far from here. Yeah, every few years they get a spectacular crash. It's so noisy. I don't know if this is a year when we have that annoying weekly, week-long, like armaments and aviation military thing at Le Bourget, where you can go buy yourself a bunch of bomber missiles and fighter jets if you want. But also it's going to be Bastille Day in 2 days, and they frequently do this stupid thing with these air shows doing the tricolor over Paris, and it's just retarded. No one here really likes Bastille Day. You know, they understand that the first French Revolution, you know, there were more in the 18th century, was an abject failure, and you know, it didn't do anything. You know, the average person who died was there. It goes again. I don't have a Zoom. Yeah, he's doing those loop-de-loops. The average person who died was the average person. I mean, that was first who died. And, second was the clergy, because the problem was they had been hearing confessions and they knew all the dirt on everybody and were potential gossips and snitches, potential, you know, and it was the reign of terror, so they had to go. And the third group was some aristocrats, and the revolution was not fomented by starving people who rioted. It was fomented by bourgeois lawyers who did it for a reason and had no problem with the monarchy. They were perfectly happy to let the monarchy stay, really. They didn't care. The monarchy was, you know, just figureheads, and they were pretty poor at that time. You know, the bourgeois were richer. And a lot of Americans think, oh, the French Revolution, it was great, off with their heads, you know. And when they start with that nonsense, I ask, well, which French Revolution do you mean? Which century? And which one in the 19th century, you know? And they're just stupefied. And if they're really obnoxious, I take them to First French Revolution sites, such as Picpus Cemetery in Paris. So they can, well, it's nice, it's a working convent, it's barely open, and it's hard to find the entrance even. But you can see the mass graves and the other ones which had been dug. And the number of people, it's like 3,000, something like that, in this one little space. And the numbers of what they did, you know, and it was ordinary people, and then clergy, you know. And they're just stupefied, you know. And I take them to some other places, you know, and I say to them, you know, all revolutions end in betrayal, and Americans get told all kinds of nonsense about history, The French do not really like Bastille Day. It's just a day off. They have a stupid parade here in Paris, and you know, it's like, oh, this building really is coming down. You see that? It's all empty. And I think it's being gutted. See those scaffolds there? And it's all blocked off, and there's security for the chantier, the work area. Well, anyway, I think you get the gist. So I don't like the noise from this stupid jet circling around. I don't like also that France wastes so much money on military. It's absurd. And actually, nobody approves. It's too much. It's too much of a percentage of the budget. And could be allocated better. Oh, it's a Saturday. Well, thanks for listening to me yap. I don't see any UFOs, but I do see some retarded military jets. Arg. Okay, bye.